So hello everyone, my name is Pranav and I am a legal intern in Lexis and Company. So in today's video I am going to talk about a very important landmark judgment which comes under the ambit of humanitarian law. And so the name for the case is Prosecutor versus Charles Taylor. It is a 2012 judgment. Certainly here is an overview of the same. So in this case of Prosecutor versus Charles Taylor, it was a landmark judgment before the trial court, before the special court for Siren Leone. An international tribunal established to address war crimes and crimes against humanity committed during the Syria-Leone civil war. Leone. So Charles Taylor, the former president of Liberia, faced charges of war crimes, crimes against humanity and other serious violations of international humanitarian law for his alleged role in supporting rebel groups in Sierra Leone. The prosecution argued that Taylor provided arms, ammunition and other support to the Revolutionary United Front, which is the RUF, rebels in exchange for diamonds, fueling the conflict and contributing to widespread atrocities. The trial was notable as it marked the first time a former head of state was prosecuted in international court since the Nuremberg trials after World War II. The prosecution presented extensive evidence, including witness testimonies, inspected communications and documentations to establish Taylor's involvement in the conflict and his responsibility for the crimes committed by the RUF. So the RUF, as you all know, it is the Revolutionary United Front. The defense claimed that Taylor had no control over the RUF's actions and argued that he was not directly responsible for the crimes committed during the conflict. The trial lasted for over 4 years and included the testimony of several key witnesses, including former child soldiers. So the Taylor was sentenced to 50 years in prison, which were later reduced to 25 years in appeal to be served in a British prison. In this case, the court found that Taylor had provided substantial support to the RUF, knowing well that they were responsible for widespread atrocities, including murder, rape, sexual slavery and recruitment of child soldiers. The case highlighted the importance of holding leaders accountable for their roles in supporting armed groups and perpetuating atrocities during conflicts. The trial also brought attention to the issue of conflict diamonds, promoting efforts to address the trade of blood diamonds and strengthen regulations in the diamond industry. So if you guys have any doubt regarding this case, so you can just ping me in the comment box and I will get back to you as soon as possible. So thank you so much guys and have a nice day.